Thank you, Lord.
Father, we thank you, we bless you, we worship you, we exalt thee because you are a good God. Thank you, Father, for this opportunity given us, O God, to come before you this morning. Thank you because you are a loving Father. Thank you because you are a good God. Thank you because you are everything. You are the breath we are breathing in. You are the life we are living. You are the reason of the season of our time. Father, we are here to hear from you again. Speak to me. Speak to through me to the end that we all shall be blessed this morning. In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
You have been expelled and you have no place here right now and forever in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. This one, you have a message titled Personal Encounter with God Demanded.
Amen.
Personal Encounter with God Demanded.
Amen.
But then this message came to me this morning at about 3 something or 4 o'clock while I was praying. To put the picture of the message on my face and it began to speak to my heart. And he said, the reason why so many Christians are misbehaving today, the reason why so many pastors are doing whatever they love to do, the reason why so many people have become the God of themselves, is because they have not truly encountered Him. It's either they were ordained by somebody, or somebody ordained them. It's either they were told who they are, or they told somebody who the people are. If anyone ever encountered God Himself, that person will know what to do. The reason why you are still doing the way you are doing, even when you are hearing the word of God, is because you have not had genuine encounter with God. The reason why I still do whatever I do sometimes is because we have not really had a genuine encounter with God personally. We have been told about Him. We have read about Him. But have you encountered Him? That is the problem. The Bible told us in Isaiah chapter 1, sorry, Isaiah chapter 6, verse 1. Our brother Isaiah is one of the greatest prophets that ever lived. He knew about Jesus, even when Christ had not been born, thousands of thousands to come. The greatest prophet in his time. He thought he was everything. He thought he was doing well. He never knew everything he was doing. He was doing them in iniquity, in sin, until he encountered Jesus. Until he encountered God. My brother, my sister, you will never cease to amaze yourself. You will never cease to misbehave until you encounter God. The Bible says in that Isaiah chapter 6, verse 1, in the year that King Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord. Sister Adejoe, can you tell someone now the day you saw the Lord? Have you seen Him? I saw also the Lord. The only way you will see Him, that Uzziah was God. Upon the throne, high and lifted up, and strain filled the temple. Above it stood the seraphim. Each one had 6 wings. With twine, he covered his face, and with twine he covered his feet, and with twine he did fly. I go to verse 5. Then said I, where is me? After the encounter with all the prophecies, with all whatever people call him, hey, the greatest man of God, some are called a great of the great, a bishop, whatever they, I don't know what they used to call it then. He said, they said, I, where is me? If you encounter God, sister, God, you will tell yourself, where is me? No matter what you think you are, you will see how useless and hopeless you are without Him. You will see how dirty you are without Him. They say, I woe is me, for I am undone. This is the man they thought he was well done. For I am undone. I am a man of unclean lip. This is a man that people are emulating, sister, and they joy. The man that people say, I want to be like Isaiah. I want to live my life the way Apostle Money is living. I want to be like this man. And the man just saw the Lord and said, hey, I am evil dirty. Can you see the reason why you don't need a man as your mentor? Can you see the reason why you must not follow the footstep of a man? Sister, you need self-encounter. My brother, we need self-encounter. I am a man of uncleanness, and I dwell in the midst of unclean people. In the midst of the people with unclean, he never knew this. He was prophesying and doing whatever he was doing in the midst of unclean people. And he thought they were clean because his eyes was black. He was full of himself. I am a prophet. I am the because of that, even when people of unclean were with him, he never saw them. Because it was, these people are, I am leading them. He was comparing himself with them. As far as they are falling in no problem, he never knew they were all there as ministry killers. All those people you are saying, these people, with this one with me, I'm covered. They might be to cover your glory. God, help me. I am in the midst of unclean lips, for my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. My sister, your eyes must be open to see Him.
Amen.
If you don't see the Lord, you will not see your sin in you. If you don't encounter God, your sin might not be canceled from you. You have to see God through God, you will see your yourself. Until you encounter God, my people, you will not know who you are. I pray God help me here in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The reason why people still live in sin or commit atrocity is because they have not had a encounter with Him, with God Almighty. The reason you have to say, ISIS or whatever they are, is because they have not met with the Lord. If they encounter Him, they will drop their gun. If that prostitute encounter Jesus, they will leave prostitution by force. The reason why your husband is still saying, who is that God? Because he has not seen Him. Until Pharaoh see God, he never let the people go. The Bible told us in Acts chapter 9, verse 1, and Saul, yet beating and threatening and slaughtering against the disciples of the Lord, went on to the high priest. The Bible says, if you read further, this man was a killer. Went on to the high priest to do what? Give me a written letter that I may go to Damascus to arrest and kill the Christians, just as the Boko Harams are doing now. The reason why they are still doing it, because they are not encounter the master. But I go straight, go time to 3. And as his journey, he came near Damascus. And so dearly, there shine round about him is a light from heaven. You need a sudden visitation of God, Mr. Man. You need a sudden visitation of God, Mr. Woman, Mrs. Woman. I don't know who you are. You are still pouting. The reason why you can still keep married for a whole day without saying, I have sinned, is because you have not encountered Him. The reason why you can still go to supermarket and still steal is because you have not encountered Him. The reason why we are still living the way we are living is because we are not encountering God. If we have encountered Him, we will know what to do. The reason why you still be hearing a gentle message, you be angry, is because you are not encountering Him. And I pray after today, somebody here will encounter Jesus in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Therefore, and he fell to the earth and heard a voice saying to him, Saul, why persecuted me? I go straight to verse 6. And he trembled. And astonished said, Lord, what wilt thou have me do? If you encounter Jesus, nobody will tell you, go and do this. You will ask questions by yourself. What would you want me to do?
Amen.
Nobody will force you to tell you, this is what you ought to do. You'll be begging, Father, I want to work. Hey, Father, I want to work for you. The reason why they are still pushing you as if you are camel going to the river is because you are not encountering Him. What would you want me to do? And the Lord said unto him, nobody encounter God and ask questions, and there will not be answer. There will be answer.
Amen.
Immediately he asked the question, and God answered him. This is what I want you to do. Have you encountered Him? Sister, in the day, what we need is self-encounter. No matter what Apostle Emmanuel might tell you, no matter the undoubted message might preach here, in time you might still doubt, but when you encounter Him, you will stop doubting.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Even no matter how you think you are close to Jesus, until you encounter Him, your closer is nothing. When Christ was on earth here, the disciples thought they knew Him. But when John saw Him in His real form, they said, hey, I thought I knew Jesus. I don't know how you think you know Him before now. Because you can pray. Because you can do whatever you are doing, you think you know Him, you don't know Him. You need encounter. I mean, spiritual encounter. The Bible tells us in Revelation chapter 1, verse 12. Revelation 1, verse 12. And I turned to see the voice that speak with me. And being turned, I saw seven candlesticks. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I go straight to 16 because of time. 17. And when I saw Him, and when I encounter Him, I fell at His feet as dead. You can't see Christ and still be boasting. Your inner being will die. Your pride will die. Your loftiness will die. I am this because you have 2,000 LL accounts. You are doing like this. You and your money will die together. Say, I fell to the ground and as dead, and laid his right hand upon me, saying unto me, fear not, I am the first and the last. And he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive forever. Amen. I have the key of hell and death. This is a man that ate with our brother, Brother John. I don't know how he was introduced to you in your church. Wherever you think you have been, you think you know him. You don't know him. Our brother never knew that he never knew him until this day. My sister, my brother, until one day, you will know how backward you have been. People may be emulating you. People may be saying, hey, this man is so holy. Hey, this woman is so this. But until you encounter him, you will tell people, shut up your mouth. I don't know nothing. I pray God will reveal himself to us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And people, when a holy man on earth encounter God, he will have sin to confess. Hello. When a righteous man, a holy man, encounter the most holy Papa, that holy place is we have sin to confess. No wonder Abraham said, our righteousness is like a filthy rag before him. If you study the Bible very well, in Job chapter 1, the Bible said our brother Job was a perfect man, a holy man, a man that eschewed evil. But when this man encountered God in Job chapter 42, he knew how dirty he was. Job 42, 44, let me read Job chapter 1. This is the Job chapter. You can read Job chapter 1, maybe from verse 1 to 3.
Job chapter 1 to 3. I read in Jesus' name. Amen. Verse 1. There was a man in the land of Uz whose name was Job. And that man was perfect and upright, and one that feared God and eschewed evil. 2. There were born unto him 7 sons and 3 daughters.
One is okay, man. You see, quality that was given to this man. A man whose that was perfect. What do we need again? A perfect man, an upright, a man that fear God and eschew evil, a one to enter heaven. Perfect qualification. But let's read Job 42, verse 4. Yeah, I beseech thee, and I will speak. I will demand of thee, and declare thou unto me. 5. I have heard of thee. Listen. Maybe you have heard of God now. You have preached about him to you. I have heard of thee by the hearing of the ear. But now, let somebody say, but now.
But now.
But now, my eyes see thee. My eyes see thee. Verses. Wherefore, behold, myself, and repent in dust and ashes. Can you see this? When his eyes saw him, when he encountered him, a perfect man, a holy man, a man that eschewed evil, a man that knows sin, we are allowed that he has sin to confess. My brother, my sister, don't glory yet until you encounter him. Don't let people lift you up. Don't let people say, tell you, hey, you are a holy man until you encounter him face to face. He said, wherefore I abhor myself and repent in dust and ashes. Why? Because I've seen you. I thought I was holy. I thought I was pure. Even when my 3 friends were telling me some things, I thought, hey, why? I am a perfect man. I'm a holy man. I remember in 2014 or so, I invited a man of God from Nigeria here. And as Apostle Thank God was leading prayer point, he said, just as we pray here, let us pray that God should have mercy upon us. Let's pray that God should forgive us. The man came on stage. Said, are you people still in this stage? Are you still having sin to confess? Humanity! Humanity! Are you still in this stage? Have you not got to the stage that you don't have sin to confess anymore? Meaning, himself has gotten to that stage that he don't need to confess sin anymore. I look from a distance. I say, you mean Apostle Emmanuel will still go to that, get to that level that I will not be confessing sin anymore? It was later I realized how, praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
A just man. When you see that the just God, you realize that you are not just anything, you are dirty. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The Bible tells us in Isaiah chapter 64, verse 7. And there is no that calleth upon thy name, that stir up himself to take hold of thee. For thou hast hid thy face from us, and hast consumed us because of our iniquity. Verse 6, 8, I mean. But now, O Lord, thou art our Father. We are the clay, and thou art our potter. And we are the work of the hands. Verse 9. Be not wroth, very sure, O Lord, neither remember iniquity for forever. Behold, we beseech thee with all thy people. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Verse 64. But we are as an unclean thing, and all our righteousness as filthy rag. We all do fade as leaves, and our iniquities, like the wind, have taken us away.
Mm.
This is Isaiah the prophet saying, our righteousness is like a filthy rag. Now, you will see some great men of God, great men of God, they'll say, we don't confess sin in our church.
Mm.
I have grown to that level that you don't confess sin anymore. Ma, I decided to get away from everyone. You know why? I had an opportunity to move with great men of God in Jaborim. I saw how empty they are.
Mm-hmm.
I had opportunity again to move with men that said they are holy. I saw how proud they are in their holiness about iniquity. I realized that the only way I can survive and enter the kingdom is to follow Jesus Christ alone.
Amen. That's
right. Is to follow him wherever he removes his feet, I will put my own there. You know why? If I put my feet in where my foot is on, and I put my feet in a trap,
yes, sir.
Worry about you.
That's true.
You need self-encounter.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The Bible told us in the book of Ezekiel, chapter 33, from verse 30. I love this place so much. You have just heard the word of God now. From verse 30. Also, thou son of man, the children of the people still are talking against thee by the wall and in the door of the houses, and speak one to another, even one to his brother, saying, come, I pray to you, and hear what is the word that cometh forth from the Lord. That some people here this morning are here for that reason. Verse 31. And they came unto thee, and the people cometh, and they sat before thee as people, and they hear the words, but they will not do them. They will not do them. After this message, they will still carry phone and still calling those fake prophets.
Mm.
They will not go back home and go on them and say, Father, I want to encounter you. Hey, Jesus, Father, how do I know you? Father, I have to know you. No! When they have more than 10 pastors, when they have more than 20 pastors, their phone book is full of pastors, they will not hear me, my sister. Mm. But I'll keep saying it. This message was given to me while I kneel down. Pray! It picture it on my face. I would not like to make somebody go to heaven and I go to hell. God forbid.
God forbid.
He said they will not do them. For with their mouth they show much love, but their heart goes after their covetousness. Man, their heart is already fixed to that pastor in Kafacha. Their heart is already fixed to that pastor in Ghana, to that pastor in Nigeria. No matter what you tell them about God, they will not hear you.
Yeah.
Your friend will shout and shout, they will not hear. Your peace will shout and shout, they will not hear. Why? Because their mind is already made up. And I pray that stony heart will be dissolved this morning in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And lo, thou art unto them as a very lovely song of one that had a pleasant voice and can play were on an instrument, for they hear the word, but they will not do them. They do them not. 33. And when this cometh to pass, lo, it come. Then shall they know that a prophet had been among them. We shall come before God on the last day, and I will tell you, you never encountered me. You will remember this message. You will know that the message was not, I didn't just get up and just open Bible. No, it was given to me because of you and because of myself. I still need to encounter him.
Amen.
You still, I don't know how far you have gone. You need to do more. I don't know how holy you think you are. You need to be more holy.
Amen.
I don't know how deep you think you are with him. You need to go deeper. Let us do more. We need a step further to actually know him. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The Bible told us, I'm filled with this. Some people thought they knew Jesus Christ. I mean, they are holy or pure. They brought a woman in adultery to Jesus Christ. Say, Father, what do you think about this woman? Because to ourselves, we know we are clean. We know we are not adulterers. We know we are just telling what to do and go out, destroy her. In verse 8, the Bible says, I'm reading John chapter 8. If you go to from verse 7, and as they keep on pressing him, he do as if he's not hearing them. Just as he do as if he's not hearing you. Hey, condemn that person. Destroy that person. Hey, that enemy, kill him. Kill her. Meanwhile, you are yourself enemy. And he's doing as if he's not hearing you. Because if he hear your answer that prayer, you will die the next minute. And as they keep pressing him, he look up and told them, you are holy. I'm paraphrasing. Appear, no problem. You want me to condemn this person who is even holier than you? This person was caught in adultery, but I'm looking at adultery, fornication, stealing, bad mind, evil heart, all in you now. Anyone that thinks you have no sin, let it throw stone first of all. And as they encounter that word from him, they begin to drop their stone one by one. Sisters, let's drop our stone today and think about ourselves.
Amen.
Brothers, it's time to drop every stone we're carrying and bury our head in shame. Job, in his holiness, buried his head in ashes. I was a man or two, so my sister, let us for ourselves that we may encounter him.
Amen.
Lord, bless what our heart this morning.
Amen.
Amen. Are you out there? You're not born again. I don't know. You need to be born again. John 3:3, except you are born again. You cannot see him. That is the word of God. Say, Lord Jesus, I've heard a word this morning. I realize I have been living against myself. What's your word upon me at this morning? I am dirty. Have mercy upon me. Wash me clean with your blood. Take my name away from the book of death. I write it in the book of life. I accept Lord Jesus Christ today as my Lord and personal Savior. Come into my life. Come and dwell in me. I am born again. I go to sin no more. Thank you, Father, for all things are passed away and all things are become new. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I pray with you if you have confessed this confession. My Father, my God, I thank you because you saved your world. I sent forth my word, and my word healed them. Father, your word has come again this morning, and many souls have been healed and delivered. I pray, O God, the grace for them to encounter you by themselves be given to them in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Ask, O God, let every ear that hear this word this morning encounter you individually in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I that preach this message, they that hear it, we all shall have the testimony of self-encounter with you to give in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
In Jesus Christ's name, I pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Before we go, I want to say, Father, I want to thank you. Jesus.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Bishop of our souls, Shepherd of our souls, Savior of our souls, Lover of our souls.